What would you do if you were told your baby has less than 2 years to live? Parents Samantha and Jeremy fought back when they received that diagnosis. They took a new course of action. This is their story.
When I was pregnant, I had a genetic carrier screening done, and it showed that I was a carrier for cystic fibrosis, familial recessive cholestasis, and spinal muscular atrophy. But when our daughter Stella was born on May 18th, 2019, she had a clear bill of health.
We took Stella to the doctor when she was 3 weeks old, and the pediatrician noticed that she was a bit floppy and her muscle tone had decreased since birth. When we would pick her up, her arms would just kind of fall to the side, her legs would fall to the side, and she didn't really have any ability to catch herself. Stella was admitted to the hospital for testing, and a week later, she was diagnosed with spinal muscular atrophy type 1, which is the most severe form of spinal muscular atrophy.
SMA type 1 babies are generally on a 24-hour breathing support, 24-hour feeding tube, and are never able to lift their head or walk, and it's typically terminal by age 2. For me, the possibility of having a child with a terminal diagnosis was horrifying. I don't think anyone's ever prepared for that.
Receiving that diagnosis definitely was very difficult, but there was a light at the end of the tunnel because Stella qualified for a new experimental gene therapy IV treatment. That was approved by the FDA just 6 days after she was born, and she received the treatment shortly thereafter.
Stella is now 8 months old and she is doing amazing things. She is holding her head up on her own and sitting with support. She can bring toys to her mouth and shake toys and bang them together and splash in the tub and pull my hair. They may seem like very little things to someone else, but for us, they're really big milestones for Stella. She is off the feeding tube for long periods of time and she only uses breathing support when she sleeps at night. We are so lucky that Stella was diagnosed when she was because we've learned that it is critical a child is treated as soon as possible. We understand that gene therapy is not a cure and we don't know what the future will bring, but we are extremely hopeful.
We are so happy to hear that Stella is doing better and we wish her and her family all the best. Our good friend and colleague, Dr. Freda Lewis-Hall of Pfizer is back, and Dr. Freda, although Stella's parents are seeing improvement, gene therapy is not appropriate for every person or every condition.
That's correct. You know, gene therapy is really complex. We still have to determine who and what diseases this is right for, and we need to understand the short-term and long-term effects of having done it. Although it may be a promising new treatment option for a number of diseases with identified genetic mutations, we still have to understand whether or not they're safe and effective to treat those conditions.
Gene therapy targets the underlying cause of disease, while many other types of treatments are typically used to relieve symptoms. It's a technique that allows doctors to treat a disorder by delivering a gene into a patient's cells instead of using medicines or surgery.
There are approximately 25,000 genes in our bodies, and we typically have 2 copies of each, one from each parent. And these genes influence everything from the color of our eyes to how our immune system works.
And a small change to our genes, whether due to a genetic mutation, maybe aging, or some form of exposure, it can alter the way we breathe, walk, or even digest food. Dr. Freda, let's talk about how we can currently use gene therapy.
Yeah, so there's several options. You can replace a mutated gene that's causing a disease with a healthy copy of that gene. Or you can inactivate or knock out a gene that's mutated that isn't functioning properly. Or you can introduce a new gene into the body that can help fight a disease.
Like with baby Stella, gene therapy creates an opportunity to assist with rare inherited disorders. And as for how it works, Stella's parents mentioned gene therapy is administered to the patient through an injection or IV.
And of course, if you want to know more, you can go to gethealthystayhealthy.com, and there's information there as well as resources.
Thank you,
And
doctor.
While you're there, you can sign up for our monthly newsletter.
Always appreciate you visiting, Dr.
Freda
Lewis-Hall. Stay tuned, more to come.